Hello, hello. Hey, good morning, Rosa.
Morning, Yvonne.
How are you this morning?
I'm doing great. How about yourself?
Good, good, good. I just want to be on camera. Hi. Hey, I just want to jump right into what we're doing here today with Community Connect. It's just connecting different people in their professions and making sure we get the message out to people. And if we can help one person get into a new home, this is what our ultimate goal will be. Rose and I were on the phone last night at 8:30 talking about something for a client. So we've been collaborating on a particular loan. Rosa, what concerns, not concerns me, what throws me for a loop is that different lenders have all different programs. Tell me about how that all works. Take the floor.
So we have the basic loans that everybody can offer. We also have different brokers that we can work with, but internally, some of the companies that I've seen have built in certain programs based on their needs or wants or what they can offer. In our company right now, we're offering a community lending program that stands out from the basic FHA, conventional loan. So with that one, we're trying to find better pricing on the rates for our customers to help them out. We also have several options on down payment assistance. On those programs, you do have to be signed up and for basic terminology, signed up with the different programs. Not everyone takes the time to take their trainings. Not everybody's signed up and has access to those programs. So those are just some of the basic things that I've seen.
Now, Rosa, tell me, Highlands Residential Mortgages, you work for out of Midland. Tell me what you guys specialize in, and or tell me about a program that you have that fits kind of like majority of the people here in the Midland, Odessa area.
The majority of the loan needs that I see is, of course, like I mentioned, down payment assistance. And it doesn't mean that you are not good at saving or that you don't have the funds,
Oh,
but
good.
there's several expenses that go into buying a home. So some of us are prepared with most of it and we're just shy of what we need. Sometimes in the negotiation, you don't get what you ask for. So that is something that we can add in as extra help. So, and of course, after we move into our homes, when we've purchased, we have expenses with furnishing and other things. So, we of course don't want to leave you at a zero balance in your account. So, if we can help with those programs, it's always a good thing. Some of the programs Highlands Residential Mortgage is standing out with is that we can help anyone from a first-time home buyer that knows nothing about buying a home to investors. So we have a
Okay.
broad selection of programs that we can work with.
What's your favorite that you like to work with that you see the majority of around Midland, Odessa?
I have a favorite is going to be a bank statement loan, just because we get from my previous experience, we would hit a dead end a lot of times with their tax returns, not being able to qualify them because they had so many expenses. So the bank statement loan has been a lifesaver for business owners. And I've always liked that program. Just it's just unique, and I've really liked learning about that program.
The next question would be is how does somebody get a hold of you to be able to, and what get a hold of you, and what are the top three things that somebody needs to have in order to get a loan? I mean, when we talk to our clients and they want to start looking for a home, I say, wait, stop, stop, stop. Let's get pre-qualified first. It just saves a big old headache and running around. Tell me about that. Top
So,
three things.
the common mistake is that you're not talking to the right people. You're getting advice from family and friends, which is always great, but what you think is going to hurt you to pre-qualify for a home may not be the right information. I do this all day. But you, as a consumer, you're out there, you like a home, you wanna, that's your goal, but you don't know exactly what's in there. And we don't expect you to know what the guidelines are, what the requirements are. So get in contact with a realtor, of course, and with a lender, and we will walk you through that process, whether it's helping you get to where you need to be, set up a plan for you. You know, this is, you'll do 10 things from now until we get you into a contract. And second, of course, we want to see a 2-year employment history. We want to
Okay.
see a 2-year residential. You know, that just, we just need to verify that you've been where you've been living for the past 2 years,
Okay.
your income, your assets, and of course, that from that point forward, we'll find a good program from you for you and see what you qualify for.
You know, I always get asked, do you do a single wide mobile home with land? Can you do a double wide with land? Can you do those?
We can do both.
You can do both.
There's certain
Awesome.
requirements, but we can talk about that once we get into details on what kind of property you're looking into,
You
what
know, Rosa,
requirements we have.
I know that they have talked about, oh, get straighten out your credit, do this. The credit debt to income ratio is a new term, I feel like, from when I cash was everything to me. Now it's really not. You know, if you have credit cards or such, it shows a certain percentage that it carries. Explain that to me just a little bit.
So, you know, there were, the guidelines changed so much. I came into mortgage in 2014 and things were already changing and everybody talked about fair lending and all the guidelines and requirements that changed, but it's protecting the consumer. We're not going to just we'll give you a loan for $500,000 without checking that, you know, that you have that cushion to be able to pay for your regular daily expenses. So that's where the debt to income comes into place, and we have to meet those guidelines.
I always say, what is that magic number? Is it 45%, 60%? How does somebody look at that?
43 back in, but there's maxed out at 55 a lot of times. So
Okay. So if we're
yes.
going to 0 to 100%, somebody needs to be right in the middle in order to get a home so they've got enough room to make their house
Yes.
payment.
Yes.
This is what I tell my clients. Listen, I don't want your house poor. We're not going to put you in something that we'd rather find out at the front end than you get into that house and your house poor. Then how would you feel?
Right. I feel the same way.
Okay. And what kind of statement would you say to that? Okay, so we talked about what's needed, and that's pretty standard, but what I'm having a tough time out there is educating our community, or that people need to get with a lender, a local lender first, and
Yes.
then start looking for property.
Yes, we wanna, the benefits of getting pre-approved is that you're not out there falling in love with the house on the corner that may be within or without, not in your budget. So maybe you qualified for more and didn't realize it either. So with the local office that we have here in Midland, and you know, Odessa and Midlands are close, we accommodate. You come into our office, we'll walk you through and answer. I'll sit with you for 2 or 3 hours if we need to. And if we have a follow-up appointment after the initial, that's fine. We want you to understand what you're getting into. And I want to make sure that you understand the process, educate you on what you need to do if you're not ready, and meet that goal that you have for 2024.
You know, I think important out here, si hablo español.
Sí. Sí, so es, mi primer idioma es español. So I'm 100% Spanish speaking, and we want to help our community also that is, even if you're bilingual and you prefer Spanish, that's what my biggest request is. I am bilingual, but I want to understand my contract. I want to understand my disclosures and sit with somebody that can explain that to them.
Okay. Is that something that you would say I specialize in? That how would somebody get a hold of you to be able to start the process?
You can reach me on my cell phone. I don't work 8 to 5. I work when my cell phone rings. So if you
I
call
love
me after
that.
5, yes, after 5 o'clock is fine. We live in a town where everybody is connected to the oil business and they don't work 8 to 5. So if you need to reach me after hours, that's fine also. And my number is 432-638-7999. And you can find me in our local office. I'm sure whenever this video is posted, we can link my information and just add the address there.
Yeah, so your office, your bricks and mortar office is in Midland. However,
Yes.
you travel around because you and I have met at Elegante. So, you travel around to the client just as I do, Rosa.
Yes.
So that's good teamwork, team effort. And I think having somebody bilingual out here where they're comfortable speaking their native language is important as well. Most important is us to get educated for our community that. Get lending first.
Yes.
I tell my client by law, we have to give them three. I say, where do you bank? Talk to them there because they might have a relationship with them. And then number two, allow me to send you three. And then number three is reach out to somebody and find out what your own credit score is. Know your numbers.
Yes, and we talk about that. Everybody has access to the free annual credit report.
Oh,
If that's
true.
something they want to do, sometimes they hold back. They don't want us to pull the credit. It's a hard inquiry, and a lot of consumers see it in different ways, so they don't want that hard inquiry. But you do have access to a free annual credit report if you want to take that and work on it yourself, and then get guidance from us.
The thing that amazes me, Roseanne, that I use Credit Karma just to kind of watch mine for safety purposes, but the thing about that is it's just a mathematical, equation with the algorithms in the back of the system that throw out a number. That isn't the one all be all, but it's definitely a tool that you can go in and use.
Yes.
What platform do you guys suggest using there at
I
Highland?
use Credit Karma for
Do
myself.
you?
It's like
Yes.
as a guide. I mean, you can see what's reporting and what's not reporting. But other than that, yes, you're correct that it's not going to give us an exact credit score.
Okay, and there's three major credit: TransUnion, Equifax, and I always forget that last one.
Experian.
Experian. So, which is the one that y'all use, or do you use all three? I don't know how that
We
works.
pull all three credit
You
bureaus.
pull all three. Okay, and then you look at them and take the best one, or do you take the
Middle score.
the
So
middle
if you've got
score?
a 700,
Good
a
info.
725, and a 750, we would go with the 725.
Okay, one more thing I want to touch on. I get a husband and wife. Wife doesn't work, but you have to use your income, but you don't. I know. Tell me about that.
So we in Texas, because it's a community property, we want to take the application for both. In that case that the wife is not working or her credit's not the best, maybe she doesn't have any credit scores, we'll still want to add her to title. We've got a little ham here. We got
Sweet
a
baby over
guest.
there. A special guest. That's sweet.
Yes.
Thank you, Rosa, for sharing her.
So from that point forward, we'll have to structure the loan. If we're keeping the husband, which is a better credit, the main income earner, maybe she's a stay-at-home wife, then we'll still add her to title, but we still have to do the inquiry to make sure that she doesn't carry any debt that he is now.
Oh.
We
Or
have
that
to
he.
add his debt on an FHA loan. But if there's different guidelines, different ways about going away, doing that. So we'll structure it based on what we need to do to make the best of
Okay.
it.
Okay. Now I got one more question. I talked to a mother and a son yesterday. The mother has the credit, but doesn't have the income because she's on SSI, Social Security. And the son has the credit. Oh, no, the son doesn't have the credit, but he has the income. You see what I'm saying? In that case, what would you recommend that somebody do?
So I've had a similar situation come up recently, and we can always help the son build credit. So if the mother, say, has a credit card that she's been using for a while, a lot of people don't think about this, but I want to do this for my kids one day. I've got two little ones, and of course, being in a mortgage, I'm already thinking about that.
Good.
Adding them to a credit card, you don't have to give them the credit card. You can add them to your credit card. You've got so many years of credit history and good payment history. They carry that over. So if we add
Sweet.
the son now, and the mother has had a credit card for the past 5 years that she's just been really good with her payments, and that will carry, it'll absorb it onto his credit. The scenario that I have right now, the son had nothing on his credit. He absorbed 93 months of credit card history, and his credit went up to 745 in a
Wow.
matter of 3 weeks. They timed it right. They added him before the payment was due, and when they reported to the credit bureau, he absorbed it, and his credit went to 745.
Wonderful. What that's what I love to hear, those good success stories. Thank you for sharing that with me. All right,
Yes.
Rosa, I want to know where they can get a hold of you, your phone number. I love it that you speak Spanish. I
Okay,
wish I
so
did. Wish I did. People think I do because my last name's Rosas. They think, oh, she speaks Spanish.
well, the good thing is that if you've
Yes.
got Spanish consumers or clients coming your way, we can help them. We can still help them as a team, and I'll sit with you. We did a couple of weeks ago. We had a couple who preferred Spanish. They were bilingual, but we all sat together, and we teamwork. We can support each other. So, yes, me pueden llamar al 432-638-7999. My phone number again is 432-638-7999, or you can reach me via email also,
Okay.
rhernandez@highlandsmortgage.com. Mi correo electrónico es rhernandez@highlandsmortgage.com. And my office is located conveniently just north of town here in Midland, across from the Midland Park Mall.
Oh, there
So it's
you go.
very
Okay.
easy to find.
I know where you're at. Okay, have not been to your office because we've always met in Odessa, Rosa. So, Rosa, thank you. This is Yvonne with EXP Realty. If you're looking to buy or sell, let me have that opportunity. I do sell land. I do dabble in a little bit of commercial. No high rise, no big, rental lease places. That's for somebody else. I'm just not. I don't feel qualified enough in that area. But let me help you. Let's show them. I'll work hard for you. Rosa will also work hard for you. Y'all take care. Happy New Year. Thanks, Rosa.
Thank you.